Hi everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So, my latest video, the one where I was putting my finger over a hole which had a vacuum behind it, many of you noticed that at the end of the video I inserted an extra clip where I had some magnets inside of a vise, and when I dropped a coin through, the coin fell very slowly. Now what's going on there is the changing magnetic field going across the conductor is inducing an electric current which is creating its own magnetic field which opposes the other magnets. This creates a breaking effect. Putting little clips at the end of my video is just something I've been doing for years now, just whatever I've got available, and yes, it is a ploy to increase my watch time. So why have I been playing with magnets? Well, I want to find out what it would actually take to stop a bullet with magnets. I think I can do it, but that's not what this video is. This video is actually about how I accidentally made a coin sorter. So I was using these pennies as kind of like a mock bullet when I was testing, and this track here to accelerate them, you know, shoot them through the magnetic field. And I noticed that the pre-1982 pennies would get slowed down more. So I've got two pennies here. This one is a 1993, and this one's a 1975. So let's run the 93 through first. You see, it went into the plastic flower pot there. It's now the 1975. It went into the glass jar because it got slowed down more, and it fell straight down after passing these magnets. Now these are actually a little bit weaker magnet because I found these strong ones here, the 1-inch diameter, 1/4-inch thick N52 neodymiums, were actually too strong. It'd just stop all the pennies immediately. I can almost move them around just by moving them in my hand. So these magnets were too strong and I had to go down on the magnet. All right, so here is a handful of coins. 10 of them are the newer copper-plated zinc pennies, and 10 of them are the older solid copper pennies. So let's run them through. You can see it can handle it as fast as I can feed them. I moved the camera so you can see them going into the pots. Let me drop them through once again. I can get them sorted. That sounds right. The zinc pennies just don't interact with the magnetic field quite as strongly. So they don't slow down as much and they're able to overshoot. And land in a different spot. Awesome. So let's see. The copper pennies. How many we got here? 75, 78, 67, 81, 78, 75, 59, 77, 73, and 79. And there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So sorted them out with 100% accuracy. How about that? So why would you want to sort out the pennies? Well, the copper ones are worth more. Plus, you wouldn't want the zinc pennies mixed with your copper pennies if you're doing anything with them. Unless you wanted to make brass, I guess. Anyway, it's not legal to melt down pennies, at least not yet. But those of you who are preparing for when it is, here's a really simple coin sorter. Somebody's probably already thought of this. Anyway, hope you enjoyed. I'll see you next time.